Fellas, Kostrowski here, DFS 5-Pack. We've covered DraftKings NBA, DraftKings MLB Early, DraftKings MLB Night Games. We've done those members only. Done a lot today, and it's not even noon Central Time, which means that sports at full throttle right now, and we are about to jump into the overlay breakdown of the day.
We sure are. Let's get it, man.
So, let's see here. Sharing. I do want to make a quick announcement. I was talking to the guys over at Overlay today, and I'm pretty sure it has something to do with the fact that as we get into the later part of the bubble right now and we're dealing with these play-in games, that guys, a lot of their matches are coming off the board too frequently, so they took down the progressive jackpot contest until the playoffs start back up, and then they'll be back up there. In the meantime, we still got MLB, and we're going to run through that first. I think we'll take our time on it today. And then we will quickly run through the NBA 5-Pick Shootout, which I know are the contests you really like anyway.
Yep, let's get it, man.
So the $22 contest has got a $3,500 jackpot right now. Not quite 20 grand, but a solid payday nonetheless.
Amen.
All right, so we're starting off with the Yankees, guys. I'm actually up a night slate for this one. Just talking through. Use some of this information. Okay, so we're going to do DJ LeMahieu and Gleyber Torres taking on Zach Eflin tonight, or Eflin. For me, I'm just going to side with the fact LeMahieu is batting 415 with 1,000-plus OPS this year, and Gleyber Torres is a flat-out stud, but he's been really struggling, so I'll just take the guy who's playing a lot better this year.
Yeah, I lean LeMahieu also, but not when I'm, like, dying to choose, but I do
It would be different, right, if we were like we were in the middle of the season and Torres was being Torres.
Mm-hmm. True.
So, because that dude's a flat stud, and it could change any day. I'm trying to think of who was it yesterday. Was it just the Diamondbacks? I feel like we're talking Diamondbacks and Ryu. Like, hadn't looked good, and then it just twitches. It switches really quickly because that's baseball.
Sure does.
Do you think you'll pick this one?
No.
Oh, okay. Judge Stanton, that's easy for me.
Judge right now, for sure.
Stanton's great, but Judge is just flat out on fire.
Mm-hmm.
All right. How about Aaron Hicks against Aaron Sanchez?
Aaron Sanchez isn't pitching tonight, I don't think. And I mean, if he is, I feel like I'd always take a pitcher over a hitter.
Yeah, this doesn't seem right. I think it's supposed to be Gary Sanchez.
Definitely supposed to be Gary Sanchez. You're right.
That'll probably get switched. I know that they were in a hurry to get the contest up.
Gary Sanchez, all Yankee hitters for sure.
Yeah, he also does not look good to start the year, so I'll take Aaron Hicks.
I'll take Hicks also, but another one I'm not dying to choose. I start really getting the ones I like with the next one.
Okay. I'm assuming you're going to pick Voit if he's in the lineup?
No, I like Gardner. Gardner looks really good right now. He's starting to get going. Home runs in back-to-back games. I like the way he looks at the dish.
Would it make any difference to you if Voit's in the five hole and Gardner's batting ninth again?
I think Gardner's from batting eighth, but either way, not a big difference. But no, it wouldn't.
Okay. I'll argue with you on that. Well, not argue, but I'll take the flip side of it. I'll go with Luke Voit. And then we get to this next one. And we got two of the game's worst hitters right now because these guys both look awful to start the season.
I'll take McCutchen, though.
All right. Any specific reason I'll come?
Because Hoskins is better against righties. McCutchen does more things. I just have a better feel about it.
Okay. Both points are 100% true. I will also piggyback off the fact these guys both look terrible to start the year. So I feel like 2 points might be enough for a winner right here. McCutchen betting 56. And Hoskins, man, it seems like forever ago when this guy lit the league on fire to start the year. Remember that?
Yeah, man, it does seem like forever ago.
I think I will actually go with Hoskins and just bank on a walk being all that I need to win this one.
Yeah, I get that, man.
Not one I'm dying to pick, though, either, because I don't detract at all from your arguments that McCutchen just does more things.
Truth.
All right. Bryce Harper versus Real Muto. So it's a tough one, too, because I like Real Muto better against lefties, but even though I'm the notorious Bryce Harper hater, guy's usually good for a walk.
Yeah, Real Muto looked good yesterday. I walked a few times, hit a homer. I'm going to go Real Muto here.
All right. The lefty on the mound, that definitely adds to your argument there. not only is Real Muto like a good hitter, not just for a catcher, but he's very good against left-handed pitching. All right. You talk me into it. I'll go Real Muto.
Cool.
Okay. Didi Gregorius and Scott Kingery.
I'll go Kingery. He'll be in the middle of the lineup.
Okay. Lefty on the mound, you're right. Gosselin versus Roman Quinn.
Gosselin easily.
I agree. All right, let's move down to these Astros versus your one of your favorite pitchers, Zach Gallen. I'll ride the hot hand of George Springer over Jose Altuve.
Same, but I'm not like dying to pick it.
Okay. I want to cover something. When they do these, because he had them a couple of times recently in NBA where they got three players in three different matchups, you can only really pick one. You can't like just go Springer. You know what I mean? Like if you pick Springer versus Altuve, you can't pick Springer versus Bregman because you cannot select this player. So
you can only pick the same player once.
Yeah. So like you could do Springer. No, you can only pick one of these Astro ones. That's what it is. So you have to pick your favorite. And I think for me, it's probably Springer. But do I want to take him against Altuve or Bregman?
Yeah, it's a great question. I don't like any of these guys enough to pick them over the other.
It's always a hard part about picking three really good hitters, right?
Yeah. And then it ends when you get to Brantley and Gurriel.
Okay. And just something you had brought up, that Springer has been, after a terrible start to the season, has really been turning things around with double-digit DK points in five straight. A lot of walks in there, too. I like that baseline of points.
Sure.
All right, Brantley versus Gurriel, what you got there?
Brantley's been out, so I'm not sure he'll be in the lineup. But if he is, I like the matchup better against Gallen. So give me Brantley.
All right, Correa versus Kyle Tucker. Give me Correa. Correa's swinging a nice bat right now.
I know Tucker just went yard, too. So Tucker's been good, but give me Correa here as well.
All right, Reddick versus Maldonado. Maldonado's cooled back down. Give me Reddick.
Reddick, easy.
Okay, sounds like that's one we'll both pick as well.
Yes.
All right, we're having a Marte Partey, Cattell or Starling?
I can't choose between these two, man. Come on, don't make me do that. I won't choose this one. Both these guys are good. I'm not going to choose it.
All right, how about Calhoun versus Christian Walker?
I like Calhoun more. Platoon advantage, got going last night. Give me Calhoun.
Same. Oh, and as far as Cattell versus Starling, I'll take Starling. I just for no rhyme or reason. I wish I had a better reason. I don't have one. Escobar versus Peralta. Both of these young men got it going last night as well.
I'll take Escobar, but that's only because I brought him up on the public video and I want to stay the course.
All right. Peralta also had a big night last night. I'll go with him just to be different on this one. Carson Kelly versus Nick Ahmed. The kid going for Houston today is a righty, although there's going to be probably some bullpen action in this game. Still, I'll take Carson Kelly.
Ahmed had been awful and homered last night. I'm going to ride the hot hand and go Ahmed.
All right. Okay, let's move on down to some of these Blue Jays guys. Which former MLB All-Stars kid do you want? Biggio or Bichette?
Both these guys are good. Toussaint on the hill. So you got, I'll take the lefty and Biggio.
Biggio with the hit last night.
Bichette had a decent game, too. He stole a bag, I know that.
I'll ride the hotter hand of Bichette.
I get it. Both these guys are good.
Yeah, I'm not going to sit here and tell you guys I consider myself an expert on either one of these guys. Being that they're both relatively new, and Toronto is not my top team to usually watch.
Truth.
Gurriel versus Vlad Jr.
I'm going to go Vlad. I just got a feeling on him tonight. He has not been good, though.
Although, three doubles the last two games.
Yes. And, like, he was visually, like, very engaged last night from what I saw. So I'm going to just go with the gut feel there.
And as a little bit of reward for everybody watching this video, click the thumbs up button. It's always appreciated. But one of Matt's sleeper stacks on the night is going to be Toronto, probably coming in at, fairly respectable to low ownership against a Toussaint who can be incredibly hit or miss.
Amen.
All right, Grichuk versus Teoscar Hernandez.
I'm going to go Teoscar. He's just been better.
Yeah. Teoscar is definitely your kind of play, too, with all these big home run games he's been having.
I mean, if Grichuk were, like, more solid, I could – I mean, listen, I don't think it's crazy to go either of these guys, but I prefer Hernandez.
All right. How about Acuna versus Freeman?
So I like the spot for Freeman better. You know, platoon advantage, had the day off yesterday. But the fact that Acuna had those stolen bases makes it hard to go against him.
Yeah. Didn't provide what I was looking for last night, but he walked twice and got caught stealing. So that having that in your back pocket is a big help for me. So I'm with you 100% on this one. I like the lefty matchup for Freeman, but he has not looked like himself this year, whereas Acuna got off to a rough start of the season but has played a lot better over the last 5-6 days. So I'll also go with Acuna.
Cool. See you eye-to-eye.
Dansby versus Ozuna.
I'm going to go Dansby. Ozuna has cooled down considerably.
You know, Swanson took the collar last night, but I don't think Ozuna did much of anything either. As I know, the Atlanta offense overall was less than stellar last evening, so I'll side with you on Swanson as well. Both of these guys are better against lefties, so that's a kind of a non-point. All right, Markakis versus Darno. Markakis hasn't even been playing, has he? Oh, he got back in the lineup last night. Or one at bat.
Darno has been awesome for them.
Yeah.
I'm going to go Darno here.
Batting cleanup last night. Assuming he's back in the lineup as a catcher, I'm with you on that one.
He's good.
All right. And then Austin Riley versus Ender Inciarte. Riley with a couple of bombs, batting 129, couple of Ks last night, but homered and took two walks the day before, which is nice.
I'm going to still go Inciarte.
It's a tough call for me. Yeah, this is one I can tell you I will not pick. This is like bottom of the list for me.
I get that.
Unless like the lineup comes out and like something funky happens with, you know, and like let's just say Inciarte was leading off, they moved Acuna to two or, you know, put Inciarte in the two hole, then that might talk me into it, but I'm probably going to abstain from that one. All right, interesting question. You talked about Tiki Toussaint on the members only video for MLB is real hit or miss. And then we know Zach Gallen is one of your favorite pitchers, but in a really crappy matchup right here. What are you thinking on this one?
I feel like I have to go with Gallen. Like,
he's your boy.
There's no way I can pick Toussaint over him. I mean, especially because I like Toronto offense.
I got you.
But like, the fact that it's a question scares me.
Yeah, I mean, again, we all want to hate on the Astros, but they're still really good. And as good as Gallen is, it is tough to pick any pitcher against them.
Yeah, exactly. Like, this could easily be an off start for him. So,
all right. We're going to move over to the NBA stuff. It's only 30 spots in this contest, so if you're trying to get in, there's 22 spots left, and by the time this video comes up, it's probably going to be about 20. So I would do it right away, and I think if we fill this up, it might put out another one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Kawhi Leonard versus Kristaps Porzingis. I will tell you right away, I lean at not picking this one because I like them both about the same.
Man, this is a tough one. Give me Porzingis, though.
I brought up Porzingis in the public video today for NBA as a GPP guy I like for the DK format. The Clippers, you know, we all know their perimeter defense is excellent, right, with a couple of the premier defenders in all the NBA, but they're slightly weaker against bigs. And even though Porzingis plays a lot more like a wing on the outside, he's still 7'3", you know, getting rebounds and block shots and stuff like that. So I'm going to go Porzingis, too. But, like, raw floor, I do like Kawhi.
Yeah, I mean, of course, especially after that loss, you got to assume he'll play well here.
Yeah, and the Clippers don't have the 2 seed locked up. Not that it necessarily makes that big of a difference, but I feel like they're going to be out there playing still today.
True.
All right, so this is a tough one. We got Luka against the Clippers or Harden versus the Lakers. Russell Westbrook is firmly questionable. I don't like the matchup really for Harden in this spot, but Westbrook is firmly questionable today, which means that getting this thing in on time, I'm going to go with Harden, and I'm actually going to pick it.
Yeah, I mean, especially with Westbrook questionable, got to go Harden, right?
Right. Houston still has a little motivation to win. So does Dallas, but this is not a good spot for Doncic. And you guys all know I've been riding Doncic every single slate so far in DK. His price is up today, which has nothing to do with overlay, but Kawhi and Paul George and the guys on here, I can see this being a personal pride day for them.
Same.
Okay. Now, if we find out Westbrook is playing, then it becomes much more of a toss-up for me, and then I'll probably try to abstain from it.
I'm with you.
Okay. Tim Hardaway versus Reggie Jackson.
Give me Reggie.
Okay. I'm going to agree with you, but purposely not try to pick that one.
I get that.
Okay. Next up, Lou Williams versus Zubac. Give me Lou Williams here. Second game back from, I love his nickname. Have you heard this one? Lemon Pepper Lou.
I have not, but I love it.
Yeah, I think it's one of my new favorite nicknames. I want to say it was Shannon Sharp who called him Lemon Pepper Lou for going out to get wings. I love it. I think it's hilarious. Not the reason I'm going to pick him, but I'll always pick Lou Williams over Zubac.
Yeah, I love that. Yeah, I'm with you.
And I will pick this one in my top five as well.
Sweet.
All right, Kleba versus Marcus Morris Sr.
Oh man, this is I'm not gonna pick this one, but give me the Morris brother.
I don't trust him, so I'll go with Kleba, who I think was a little bit more needed. But this is one I'm gonna look into a little bit further when we get off here, so I don't have a very strong opinion on it yet.
Cool.
All right, Lillard or Jokic? Give me Jokic because the missed shots for Lillard.
Yes. Give me Jokic as well.
And I fully expect both of these teams to play hard today.
They both play for something?
I mean, for me, I think Denver would love to get up to that 2 seed. Like, they're right there, game back for Clippers. I think it's almost like a pride thing for them.
So what teams aren't really playing for anything today? Is it anyone but the Lakers?
The Lakers are the main one.
Okay.
The Bucks maybe, too. I don't know. I have absolutely no idea what to expect out of my Bucks today.
Right. We'll talk about that more when the video's over. I gotcha.
Okay, so I'm going to go Jokic, not when I'm lining up to pick. And then Melo versus Millsap. If Millsap plays, I guess he's questionable, which I just saw. I'll pick Anthony. Right now, I just don't trust Millsap's minutes. I used him yesterday, and he was excellent in the time, but he lost run to Jeremy Grant, tail end of a back-to-back for a veteran.
Give me Melo. The revenge tour continues.
Yeah, I got Melo on this one. All right. Whiteside versus Trent Jr., I'm going to pick Whiteside here. And Trent's been really excellent, but all he does is shoot threes.
Keep in mind that you only pick five, so this is not one I'm going to pick. But I'm with you. I'll take Whiteside as well.
All right, we'll move down from there. LeBron versus Anthony Davis. This is one I'm really cautious about because I can completely see – this is why I don't like today's NBA slate as much as I would. I don't know what to expect from the Lakers today. I could see on the tail end of a back-to-back, I could see one or both of these guys sitting. I could see them playing hard to get back to their winning ways after a terrible game yesterday. I could see them doing what the Bucks did, where they played the first half and then they sit their guys in the second half. My biggest hesitation on NBA today overall is I frankly have no idea what to expect out of the Lakers, who legitimately have nothing to play for.
So, yes, but taking that out because we don't know, I love AD here. So, give me AD.
Agreed.
We don't know. And you have to, especially for here, how we have to choose between them. Give me AD.
And because there's alternates, I actually have this as my, being my top one. But it's my hesitation on pay sites today, too, because it's the last game. Yeah. And I don't want to prioritize Anthony Davis. And then all of a sudden, he's out.
For sure. I get that.
And I got no sub. But we've watched Brooke Lopez go for 48 DK points. We watched Nurkic at almost no ownership. Only reason I snuck into that money that day, absolutely dominate Houston. They don't have a big guy. How are they going to check Anthony Davis? He should go insane today.
Yep.
If he plays. All right, Tucker or House?
It's if Westbrook doesn't play, it'll open up more rebounds for Tucker, I think. But I think they need House more, so give me House.
Yeah, I would pick House, but I wouldn't go with it. And then for MPJ versus Covington, just give me the hot hand right here. Michael Porter Jr. is going insane. And if Millsap and Murray are out today, look for the Porter Jr. show to continue.
I'm with you, man.
And I'll pick that one. It scares me. Porter Jr. is funny. Because the idea of expecting him to go 3 for 3 like he has the last three games is scary. The idea of fading him is scary. It's a weird pick.
Yeah, definitely. Man, that game's a good one. Nurk going against his former team. I want to watch that game.
Blazers are fun to watch right now. Yes, 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 and yes.
Sweet.
All right, guys, best of luck today. Go get Lemon Pepper Lou into your lineups, and we'll see you all probably tomorrow then.
Thanks, guys.